we are talking about today a little bit of something which is called interaction for virtual reality. Because today, we can interact with it with something which is called a joystick, which is really good for playing. But when we are thinking about other kind of interaction, like grabbing an object, clicking a button, today it's not actually possible because we can't see our hand, but more important, we can't touch and feel the object that we are interacting with. Why is that important? Because virtual reality is about recreating the world that we have around us, but we interact with this world with our hand. And today, it's not possible to interact with that natural action in virtual reality. So we built a device, which is showing here on this finger, that is capable to recreate the sense of touch while interacting with the object. So that's what we can do. So if you see a button, you can click a button, but actually you can feel it. But when you can feel it, you can forget that you are in virtual reality, at least for these basic human interaction strategies. Because if we can make someone click a button, that means that we don't have time to explain him what he has to do. Because it's so natural to see something and click it with his hand. But without feeling it, it doesn't work. So Charlie, please click that button. So what we saw is that when we integrate this kind of haptic technology, so touch interaction, the user is able to perform faster in virtual reality. Like independent assessed studies says that we are able to go the 30% faster while interacting. But why is it important? Because if we cannot touch and interact naturally, we cannot train effectively in the virtual reality. Right now, we have a fire, and Charlie is interacting with it. But without giving to the user the information that the fire is dangerous, how can he learn it? So our device can convey efficiently and effectively touch sensations, vibration sensations, which are giving the alert not to go there, different kind of button, so you can train for different kind of machines. And with multiple devices, it's able also to let you manipulate virtual objects. So we see the difference in performance between a hand equipped with this device compared with the hand which is not equipped. The virtual object is there, but when we are interacting it without the sense of touch, the interaction is way more violent because we don't know where is it. We have to rely on our visual input. And that means that is frustrating for the user. And it's not, you have to think about what you're doing instead of the task that you should perform. The system itself, it's able to also be integrated with any kind of content. So we can play music. Charlie, you can go to the next scene. It's actually able to play music, but we can use it on as many fingers as you want, concerning the level of immersion that you want to give to your user. The most relevant application today are, as we said, professional training, showcasing scenarios, because if you want to show to a customer something to buy, being able to touch it, manipulate it, can create a physical bonding with it, and it can increase the ability to sell the objects, because today it's not possible. Another really interesting application is for engineering. In virtual reality, engineering is extremely easier because we can visualize the 3D objects, but we don't have a tool to actually do it. This system is integrated with all the chain, is totally cross-platform, and is capable to introduce the third sense, the touch sense, into virtual reality. And it's available for pre-order for professional users starting from September on our website, www.gotouchvr.com. And with this system, you will be able to make all of the action that we described, manipulate, touch, discriminate texture, in a totally wireless and integrated platform. So the message they want to convey today is that virtual reality, up to today, is great, but being able to interact with it is the next step for this kind of total immersion. It's possible to do it with exoskeleton like Iron Man, but they are quite expensive. We are giving the minimum viable solution to be able to interact and be immersed without being blocked by the hardware that we are wearing. So with this, I'm concluding, and we are there in the booth near at booth G20 in GoTouch VR. If you want to come and try it, that I really suggest you to do it, because it works. We are there to make you a lot of demos. Thanks a lot.